So really remarkable. This comes from a book of motets, what you just heard, the setting from the Song of Solomon. At the same time in England, Thomas Tallis, the next song composer you'll hear, is writing in the same kind of music. You can hear the words moving together, but this British Renaissance has kind of a sweet, sad quality to it. And this setting, taken from the Gospel of John at the Last Supper, I think kind of summarizes Jesus is called the disciples that we love one another. This is A New Commandment by Thomas Tallis.
Thank you.
forget things. Even this week, I forgot a couple of our singers' names, which is a good reminder that even as you walked in, you can see on our television screens a listing of our students. You can see it in your program. And I wanted to acknowledge two people that I did not acknowledge in the program but are very important to our success tonight. Becky, who's working our lights and sound. Thank you, Becky. And Duke, who's helping us with some audiovisual reporting. This next selection is maybe one of the most loved works in the choral repertoire. Maurice Durfly was very picky with the music that he composed. He did really self-critical. And this comes from a set of four motets. This particular motet he dedicated to the director of the Gregorian Institute in Paris. And I'm always kind of intimidated to do this song because everyone knows it, but at the same time, it is so well written that I want to make sure that I've got a choir that can do it well, and I think we found a really good match with this group. This is Durafle's Ubi Cadica. Selections are in the secular realm, separated by about 80 or 90 years, actually. Samuel Barber wrote this set of songs called Reincarnations between 1937 and 1940. And this song, The Coolin, is just a wonderful story about what would happen if we went for a walk, we held each other's hand, had a drink, just enjoyed each other's company. And then the following song actually was the last song that I picked. But I was looking for something that said love in a different way. And the irony is that Michael Englehart's setting, he only uses one word. It's only love. So I would encourage you, as we go through different vocal colors, as we go through different dynamics, that you allow yourselves a moment to think about whom you love, what you love, and how you give love to others. We're in a desperate need for love in our world today. So perhaps getting a head start now, we can share that with those around us.
Thank you.
You might have looked at the program and thought, isn't that from the German Requiem, ein deutsches Requiem? Yeah, it is. And it's a little spoiler for what we're going to be presenting in May. In short, I want to follow Brahms' example in creating a human requiem as a memorial to those still living. More on that in April, but this, of course, is probably the song you know if you know the Requiem at all.